Welcome back to Travel Show Live. Things are going to get very interesting very quickly here. Thank you very much for joining us. Are you excited, John, about this segment?
Absolutely.
Because I've been asking. I love they just say yes. It's funny to me.
It's great.
Yes, sir, Mr. Hastings, sir.
Oh, no, we're not going to do that again. Because we're going to answer this question, which I love, which is, you want to go where? That's right. And did you like it? I rehearsed it all week. I was thinking, I was in the mirror. I was like, I wonder if I should say, you want to go where? I don't know. Anyway, yeah, exactly. So where is the emphasis? And fortunately, Jeff Blumenfeld is actually here in the studio. How you doing, man?
I'm good.
Welcome.
I'm good. You know, the name of the title comes, I help companies find explorers who take their products to the ends of the earth to demonstrate how those products work.
How they work. Okay.
And so when these people call me, very often I'll say, you want to go where? So a guy calls me up and he says he wants to climb a mountain in Antarctica, and I say, is it the tallest? He goes, well, no, it's not the tallest. And I say, well, why would anyone want to sponsor you? He says, because the mountain's named after me.
Oh.
He was the last surviving member of Admiral Byrd's expedition. So I said, you want to go where? You want to climb a mountain named after yourself? That actually sounds pretty interesting.
Why not? Where was the idea? Where did it come from?
For the book?
Yeah.
Oh, well, for 15 years I've been writing a newsletter called Expedition News about adventure marketing.
And we can find that online, right?
ExpeditionNews.com.
Okay.
And I've had all this material, and I met an agent, and I started explaining this process to him. You want to go where? Well, you want Mount Antarctica, you know, you want to climb Antarctica. Mm-hmm. And the agent says, well, let's try to turn that into a book. And I got a book contract, and it came out a couple of months ago.
Makes a lot of sense. I always get a little, you know, I remember reading something about this book, and I remember thinking to myself, now, I guess it's a good idea if you can put it together. Mm-hmm. To get paid to travel.
These are not vacations, so don't think someone's going to pay to have you lie on a beach.
Sit on the beach.
In St. Bart's. But if you have a project, if you have a project that's bigger than you are, if you have a project that benefits a worthy cause, or a project, for instance, that researches some mystery in science, researches what happened to Amelia Earhart. Mm-hmm. If you have a project that's an expedition, or it could be a project that's just a fun adventure that kind of will stimulate the imagination of people.
So these are larger than life projects?
Larger than you. Possibly now, not larger than life, but larger than you.
What about something larger than my ego? I don't think there's anything.
Nope.
Yeah, see, exactly. Yeah. Need I say more?
It's got to help somebody else.
Right.
in a bigger studio.
Greg Mortensen, perfect example. He's a climber.
Right.
He comes down from his climb, and his Pakistani villagers help him recover from the climb. He says, who are those girls over there? And those are girls studying their lessons. They have no school. Mm-hmm. He comes back, and he decides he's going to help build those schools. Mm-hmm. And so he develops a sponsorship. He builds the schools. He comes out with a book. Books did great on the New York Times bestseller list. It's still out there, called Three Cups of Tea. Mm-hmm. That's an example of a project that's bigger than you are.
I see.
He didn't go to these companies and say, I want to climb another mountain. And in Pakistan, he said, I want to build schools for these people. Mm-hmm. Perfect example of a project that's bigger than you are, a project that answers the so what question. So you want to climb Everest.
Yeah.
Well, so what? It's been climbed.
Right.
Oh, but you're blind? Well, now that gets interesting.
Right.
And a blind climber did go and get sponsorship to climb a mountain. First one ever to do it, who was blind, Eric Weidenmeyer.
Wasn't there a recent story about, was it a paraplegic or?
Yes, and there have been.
It was like one of the first.
Yes.
That's incredible stuff.
Incredible and great motivation for other people that are handicapped in a similar manner.
Mm-hmm.
So you've had asthmatics climb Everest, you've had people suffering from diabetes. What they're trying to say is your life's not over because you are blind. There are still challenges you can meet. Mm-hmm. And it's a great inspiration story.
One of the things you talk about in the book is, you know, you read the book, you get excited about a project, you think, okay, I can go out and do this. But in fact, what you probably, your first step should be is to go out and join another project.
Right. You want to be an apprentice in somebody else's expedition. Mm-hmm. A sponsor says, well, you want to climb Mount Everest. Where have you climbed before? You need to sign on somebody else's.
Right.
You need to do the training. You need to take a NOLS, National Outdoor Leadership School course. Mm-hmm. Go into Outward Bound. Give us some confidence that you know what you're doing. Mm-hmm. That's for an expedition. But it could be a great adventure, like the guy that hit a golf ball across Mongolia, 1,300 miles, over 400 golf balls, and he gets on the Leno show, and he finds sponsorship for that.
Of course,
so it doesn't have to be Mount Everest.
But the question is, did it go in the cup?
Did it go in the cup?
I mean, really, is it a holding one or not?
Another
still
woman.
Still trying.
There's a woman. Her name is Barbara Hillary. You'll see her on the web, BarbaraHillary.com. Mm-hmm. She wants to find sponsors to go to the South Pole. Mm-hmm. Why would anybody want to sponsor an African American, 77 years of age, artificial knee, lung cancer survivor, lives in Far Rockaway. I mean, it doesn't add up. This is not Sir Edmund Hillary.
Right.
Her last name's Hillary, no relation. Why would anyone want to sponsor her? Here's why. She just got back from the North Pole. She got sponsorship to go to the North Pole and skied the last bit of distance to the North Pole. So that's an example of doing your homework.
Yeah.
Becoming an apprentice, going on a little baby step before you want to take the big step.
You know, you'd be a good person to ask about this, too. What about these volunteer vacations? I mean, it's very chic. It's very, like, hip and cool. Oh, I'm on a volunteer vacation. You know, it's like people do, but they're actually paying to go on a volunteer vacation.
Correct.
What's that all about?
Well, I think that's terrific. There are scientists out in the field. They need help.
Yeah.
The scientists don't have the manpower. They don't have the grant. They can't hire people to keep digging,
right?
You know,
just
endlessly.
Just keep digging.
You go on a trip. Yeah. You pay to go on a trip like that. It'll be the hardest week you've ever gone on.
Right.
But you get the satisfaction that you're doing some scientific research.
Yeah.
You're getting experience, possibly to go on your own trip yourself.
Mm-hmm.
And that's a self-funded adventure vacation.
That's cool.
A volunteer vacation, like Earthwatch.org has dozens of them you can sign up on and do legitimate research while you're out there. So you get a taste of what it's like.
Plus, you get to do it for someone else.
And you do it.
Somebody else benefits, you know,
and
other than just you.
Great experience.
Yeah. So, I like it. Where can I buy the book?
Amazon.com,
that's
major
easy.
Bookstores, easy way.
I mean, I don't need another one. I have one already. But will you sign mine before
yes,
you leave?
Yes, absolutely.
All right. Jeff, thanks for doing this today.
Yeah, thanks, Eric.
I really appreciate it. All right. We will continue here on Travel Show Live. All you have to do is stay right where you are.